A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 5th June, on the front page you have, in a relief for Kiran Bedi, Supreme Court restrains Puducherry government. So, Puducherry government has been restrained now. The Supreme Court has barred decisions having financial implications or transfers. So, the Congress government in Puducherry, the Union Territory, has been restrained. So, this was a case which has been going on. It was an urgent plea by the Union government and Ms. Bedi's office for clarity on the issue of control over bureaucrats in the wake of the conflict between Lieutenant Governor and the Chief Minister. And below you have, Kerala confirms one case of Nipah. So, we had seen yesterday how one patient has been segregated and steps have been taken, and now the tests have confirmed that he is suffering from Nipah virus. And here you have, patients turn litigants as new rules stall therapy. So now several critically ill patients have been forced up to appeal to the Delhi High Court to make a case before the Delhi High Court, because suddenly they have stopped getting medication following the implementation of the new drugs and clinical trials rule 2019. So, it says, according to the March 19, 2019 notification issued by Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, stem cell derived products are under the definition of new drugs. So, such formulations, it is said now, have to be mandatorily approved by Central Drug Standards and Control Organization. So, these new rules require clinics engaged in such new drugs therapy to acquire a marketing license. But there is no provision for an interim arrangement for patients during the application process. So, patients are stranded, they are not getting medication. So, this is the issue. Then on the front page, you also have, UGC gives 6 months to fill faculty vacancies. So, all colleges, universities and deemed universities have been given 6 month deadline to fill up their faculty vacancies via process that will be monitored at every step by Ministry of HRD and UGC. And they have been warned that if institutions fail to meet the deadline of 6 months, UGC grants may be withheld. Then on page 10 you have, Kerala takes steps to stop spread of Nipah. So, team with members from various institutes under Union Health Ministry have reached the state of Kerala to tackle the Nipah virus crisis here. And police have flagged fake messages on social media too in Kerala. Then on page 11, you have this news continuation from the front page. This we had covered in news yesterday, the front page news on AN-32 missing in Arunachal Pradesh. And below you have, Centre refuses to divulge CIC selection details. So this is regarding Central Information Commission. The selection process as such for 4 new Central Information Commissioners, the details of these are sought, but Supreme Court order has directed the centre to provide the details too, but central government has refused to reveal the details. The only information disclosed is that 256 people have applied for 4 vacant positions which were advertised 5 months ago. And this is, Navy Chief issues guidelines on austerity and equality. So, the recently appointed Chief of Naval Staff, Admiral Karambir Singh, he took charge and he has issued a series of 26 measures to the rank and file of the force on social and ceremonial practices towards optimal utilization of manpower and resources. And below you have, CSIR orders probe into journals. So, this is Council of Scientific and Industrial Research. It has ordered investigation into journals because large scale manipulation and duplication of images have been found in 130 papers. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is a parting note. So, this is regarding Bahujan Samaj Party, BSP's resolve to go it alone in UP. It's a front page news and it's political news. So, this is the editorial on that. And this is low tactics. So, this says that India and Pakistan must cease targeting each other's diplomats and their guests. So, this is again some allegations which have come forth regarding Iftar party which Indian High Commission hosted in Islamabad, that guests who attended, they have been harassed. Then the lead article is the immediate neighborhood. So this says that SAARC still has the potential to become a platform for South Asian interests and shared growth. So this is regarding the regional grouping which has not reached its potential because of conflict between India and Pakistan. and this is decolonizing the Chagos archipelago. So this is an important issue, and it says India can play a pivotal role in bringing about an agreement among Mauritius, US and UK. So this is regarding the Chagos archipelago. The United Nations has also, General Assembly has also voted last month by a huge majority, 116 out of 193 members, to demand that UK withdraw its colonial administration within 6 months over Chagos archipelago in Indian Ocean in favor of Mauritius. So archipelago belongs to Mauritius and not to UK, and UK is also hosting US military base at Diego Garcia in Chagos archipelago. So it's a non-binding vote, but it is a rebuke to UK government. So this is an important issue, and it has been in news quite often earlier too. Then on the OPED page, you have fine-tuning the education policy. So this is regarding the draft education policy. It says, the article says that details about financing and institutional structures must be fleshed out. So those are not detailed out. On page 15, you have Tokyo seeks 2+2 meet with foreign defense minister. So Japan is seeking 2+2 meet. So S. Jayashankar, the external affairs minister, and Japanese counterpart have spoken about this on phone. So we have this 2+2 dialogue with USA. So now even Japan is seeking the same. So these are two ministers from Indian side and two ministers from Japan side, and these two are foreign and defense ministers. And this is transgender rights bill to be reintroduced. So in the first 100 days of Narendra Modi government second term, social justice and empowerment ministry will reintroduce the lapsed transgender persons protection of rights bill 2016. So this is one decision taken, and also 3000 crore errors in scholarship schemes for scheduled caste students will be paid. Then there is no new news on international page. The same news we have covered about warning from US to travelers to warnings from China on its travelers to US, Sri Lankan Muslims being targeted. So all this, even Sudan's crisis in which military is using force and the protesters continue civil disobedience, demanding democracy, a civilian head rather than a military council ruling them. So all these are same old news items, we have covered it, so there's no recent significant development. On business page, you have global growth to slow in 2019, says World Bank. So this is World Bank report. It has said that forecast for India through 2021 remain intact, and prognosis for impact of US-China trade tensions are grim. Because of US-China trade tensions, global growth is also slowing down, is evident now. And this is RBI study moves boost to acceptance infrastructure for digital payments. So we had seen regarding Nandan Nilekani committee as appointed by the RBI on digital payments. So here the details regarding what RBI's study suggests is given in detail here. Then this is India joblessness data not factored into World Bank growth estimates. So when World Bank growth estimates have come, they have not factored in joblessness data because that has recently been published. So this is regarding that. Then on the last page, you have an experimental Ebola cure may also protect against Nipah virus. So 4 out of 8 monkeys infected with Nipah virus survived after this dose of Ebola, that is remdesivir. So this is an experimental drug. So this is the news. And this is food safety is everyone's business. So World Health Organization has said that an estimated 600 million cases of foodborne diseases occur annually around the world, and food safety is an important issue. And lastly, here you have India at 95 on gender index. So this is first ever sustainable development goals gender index. So out of 129 countries ranked, India ranks 95. So this index has been developed by Equal Measures 2030. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.